Welcome to Chemistry with Caroline. In this video, we're going to look at how to draw resonance structures for molecules with a positive charge and how to show the arrows that show the movement of electrons throughout that molecule. So when you have a positive charge in a molecule, the electrons are going to move towards that charge. So that makes it at least easy to know where to start. And the particular molecule that I've drawn here, on the left-hand side of the positive charge, I have a pi bond. And on the right-hand side of the positive charge, I have a heteroatom, in this case an oxygen atom, and it has lone pairs of electrons on it. So I actually have electrons adjacent to that positive charge on either side, so I could start going either direction. So I'm going to start from a lone pair of electrons on the oxygen. Those can fold down to be shared between the oxygen atom and the carbon that was electron deficient, the carbocation, and that will give me this structure over here. So my oxygen atom was neutral, it donated electrons, so it's now positively charged. My carbon atom was positive, it accepted electrons, and so it's now neutral. So now my overall structure is still positively charged as it should be. In this case, the oxygen atom is the atom that has the positive charge on it. So I can't go any further to the right. This carbon right here that's on the other side of the oxygen is an sp3 hybridized carbon. It has four single bonds. It doesn't have any room to accept electrons, and it doesn't have any electrons to donate either. So it's not going to participate in resonance. And the presence of an sp3 hybridized carbon with four sigma bonds is typically going to be an indicator to you that you cannot complete any more resonance on that side of the molecule. I could, though, go to the left-hand side. And so there's two ways that you could do it. You can redraw the molecule, if you want to, that you started with and just start going to the left-hand side. Or you could move two arrows at a time. So we could move this pi bond back onto the oxygen, and that would have restored the carbocation, and we know that it would next be this pi bond who would come over, so we could move that one over at the same time. If you prefer to just redraw the first structure, that's totally fine. Whatever is easier for you and makes more sense is the right thing to do in terms of getting a grip on resonance. So if I move those two arrows, I'm now to a different resonance structure that I have not yet seen before, where my carbocation is at that central carbon between the two pi bonds now. And I can keep going because I have another pi bond adjacent to the newly formed carbocation, so these electrons could fold in because they are next door to one another. And that would give me this structure with my carbocation on the end. And now I don't have anything on the other left-hand side, so there's no further that I can go. So this has been an example of how to do resonance in an organic molecule with a positive charge on it. In this particular case, there was resonance contributors on the right-hand side and the left-hand side. And so you can start on either side. You just want to make sure that you get all valid resonance contributors when you're drawing those arrows. If you like this video and you found it helpful, please like, subscribe, and share with your friends. Thanks.